An inversion is a chromosomal mutation wherein a segment within the chromosome breaks at two ends, changes orientation by 180 degrees, then reintegrates into the same chromosome. There are two types of inversions. A pericentric inversion includes the centromere in the inverted segment, and a paracentric inversion does not include the centromere. In general, genetic material is neither gained nor lost in an inversion. An individual who is heterozygous for the pericentric inversion has one chromosome with the normal order of genes and the other chromosome with an inverted segment. The homologous chromosomes pair to the best of their ability in meiosis, and this means that the pairing of the inverted segment with the normal segment will produce a loop called an inversion loop. The problems arise when a crossover occurs within the inverted segment between a normal chromosome and an inverted chromosome during meiosis. Crossovers can give rise to viable and inviable gametes. If a single crossover occurs within the inversion loop, four different chromosomes are produced. The first chromosome, where no crossover event occurred, has the normal order of genes. This is a viable gamete. The second chromosome was involved in the crossover. It lacks genes E, F, G, and H, and is duplicated for gene A. Due to the deletions and duplication, the gamete produced is inviable. The third chromosome was not involved in the crossover. This chromosome is identical to the original parental inverted chromosome. Because it contains all the genes, even though they are in a different order, the gamete with this chromosome is viable. The fourth chromosome was also involved in the crossover. It lacks the A gene and is duplicated for genes E, F, G, and H. Due to the deletion and duplications, it also produces an inviable gamete. In summary, a single crossover event within a heterozygous pericentric inversion gives rise to two viable and two inviable gametes.